here's the thing about self-doubt. It makes us play small. It makes us make small choices. Like, I'm going to charge just this little bit for my work. I'm not going to charge what I really think I should be charging because I'm doubting myself. Or, you know, I'm going to take another year to get my website up and running because I'm not so sure I can do it. Or self-doubt is, I'm just going to walk around the block once instead of actually signing up for a real fitness and nutrition program because, I don't know, I doubt myself, and if I fail, then nobody will see me fail. So it makes us play small, it makes us make small choices, it makes us live here in like this tiny little box, whereas that, remember we were writing down our ideal versions of ourselves, like who we really want to be, is so much bigger. But when we're focusing on self-doubt, when we're consumed with self-doubt, it makes us play down here. It's no good. So you might think that your self-doubt is just hurting you. Who cares? I can break promises to myself. Nobody knows. I can play small. I can take as long as I want. I can let the self-doubt consume me. It's just hurting me. Who cares? But it's not true. Playing small and your self-doubt hurts everyone. It hurts everyone. It hurts you. So you're not starting your business, you're not getting control of your procrastination, you're not losing weight and getting healthy, you're not focusing on your relationships. It helps, it hurts you. It hurts your loved ones. Yeah. So if you are trying to help out your family by earning more money for your family, so maybe your spouse doesn't have to work so hard, or maybe you can provide a better life for your kids, you're playing small. That's not helping them. And it hurts, most importantly maybe, the people who can be inspired by you, the people that you can actually help. So by playing small and letting your self-doubt consume you, I think you kind of understand how that can affect your business so you don't help as many people as you could help. So if you're just focusing locally because you're trying to play small and you don't really want to deal with online, you're missing out on hundreds, thousands, millions of people who can be lifted up by what you have to offer. If you're not getting fit and healthy, you don't know who's watching you. Who's watching you? Who's looking at you as a role model? You might not even know it. They're seeing what you think you're capable of, and in turn that affects them, what they think they're capable of. Like your kids are watching you. Your nieces are watching you. You need to realize that there are people who are being inspired by you, or they're feeling self-doubt because you're letting your self-doubt consume you. This is like really, really heavy. I said this before. You owe us. You owe it to the world to put your gifts out there. Owe it to all of us to be wildly successful because we are depending on you. There are people you haven't even met yet, people you don't even know who need you desperately. We need you to be successful. We need you to work through your self-doubt. We need you to believe in yourself so that we can believe in ourselves.